chapter, we read these words. Jesus came and told his disciples, "I have been given complete authority in heaven and on earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." As we come to celebrate Courtney's baptism, I wanted to remind you of a few twin truths about baptism. The first is that baptism is not necessary for salvation, but baptism is a sign of salvation. That is, while baptism is really important, baptism doesn't save anybody. Only Jesus' death and resurrection and our trust in him, that is what saves us. But a baptism is a sign that you have accepted Jesus as your Savior, and it's a sign that you are a Christian and want to follow God. So the twin truths that it's not necessary for salvation, but it is a sign of salvation. There's also the twin truth that baptism is an individual event, but also a community event. It's an individual event because Courtney, or whoever is being baptized, comes alone, and they are making the individual decision to say, "I'm a Christian, I want others to know about it, and I want to follow the Lord." But it's also a community event, in that many of you have played a part in Courtney's spiritual growth. Her family, her church family, our youth group, Lakeside Christian Camp, and all of us as a Christian community celebrate in this event together. And then finally, there's the twin truth that baptism is both a commitment, serious thing, and a celebration, a glad thing. It's a commitment, a serious thing, to say, yes, I'm a Christian and I want to follow Christ. In some lands where this is done, it would mean persecution, perhaps from family members or even the government. While it's serious, it's also a celebration, because it signifies that Courtney is a child of God. It signifies that she wants to follow Christ. And so we celebrate, sometimes with smiles, sometimes even with tears, this morning, that Courtney is taking this step. Courtney, please join me. Courtney, have you asked Jesus to be your Savior, and is your desire to follow him as Lord? And Courtney, I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
On trusting in the Lord no matter what you face, and keep your eyes on Jesus Christ and live in his sweet grace. Lord, you have filled the world with joy by giving us the gift of Jesus. Bless Courtney today so she may be filled with joy. I pray that she will continue to grow closer to you and feel your presence, always knowing she is never alone. Help her to be a light to others who have not yet found you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us with Courtney. I have seen her love for you and your love in her. Help us as her parents, family, and friends to continue encouraging her love for you and to bring glory to you. In your precious and holy Son's name, amen.
One thing I can only imagine, which I know a lot of you know, in this song is Courtney's choice of the baptism. Let's stand together.